My name is Harsh.
And I'm Shreyas.
And what are we doing today, Bhatia?
We're doing The Boys.
From Amazon Prime. This is the latest series. It's a superhero series with a twist.
Also, this is Goodbye to Filmy. Let's not forget.
Oh, yeah. Obviously, welcome back to Goodbye to Filmy, guys. Sorry about that.
Yeah, so...
What's the twist here?
The twist here is that what if superheroes, supposedly...
Justice League movies?
Yeah.
A lot of inspiration from there.
Yeah, turned out to be assholes, basically.
Oh, yeah. So this entire series follows a group called The Boys, I'm guessing.
Yeah. They're the boys. Yeah, yeah.
So, yeah. And this is a story about how these guys fight off superheroes.
Yes.
Which is a very fresh take, very fresh perspective, yeah. A new direction for the entire superhero genre in particular.
Yes, we've never seen this before. This is pure satire.
Exactly.
It's not a funny parody. It's very serious stuff.
With a lot of comedy there as well.
With a lot of comedy, for sure.
Obviously.
But yeah, these superheroes basically are up to no good.
Yeah.
And in the eyes of like the media and the nation, they're like your shining
light. They're gods, pretty much.
And their brands.
Oh yeah, of course.
Yeah, so I think that's a take.
I'm pretty sure if there were superheroes in our world right now, they would be corporates pulling strings and doing their shit.
I think it's very similar to what Disney is doing with their like marketability and the toys and the Marvel.
Compared Disney to what?
to what international. Of how these characters use as brands and sellable items. I think these particular characters, we've got rip-offs of Wonder Woman, Flash, Captain America and Superman together.
I'm guessing Batman and Black Noir are pretty much the same.
Sort of.
Yeah, ninja guy with stealth and all of that.
Right.
So you've got a lot of inspirations from DC and Marvel, the superheroes there.
Yeah.
And I had a lot of fun with this, man.
I tried to have fun.
Yeah, different opinions, but let's get into the goods first. Yeah?
Let's do that. Okay, starting with the goods, I think I have very few. So for me, I actually survived through this whole season because of Carl Urban as
the Butcher.
As William Butcher, Butcher. Oh my god, like this guy is such a-hole dickhead, but with the right motivation.
Dude, firstly, Carl Urban as an actor, I love him.
He's cool.
Anything that I've seen him had like Dread, Star Trek, whatever, I've always loved. I really like the Dread reboot, man. That was Dread. I mean, I'm really sorry, so Sylvester Stallone was not Dread from
please.
The comics.
I prefer that. But anyways,
but yeah.
We actually last saw him in Ragnarok.
Oh yeah, we did.
Yeah, I call him Des and Troy. Together, Destroy. Yeah, so he's very lively.
Absolutely. He carries this entire series, more or less. He's the big name in the series. He's
absolutely.
The one carrying everyone.
Yeah.
He's the one getting the boys together. He's the one forming the group against the superheroes.
Yeah.
And, he's a big role play.
Yeah, and he has like random quips, random lines. Where is this going?
And it's
like
brilliant. Hilarious. This guy is hilarious. He's abusing left, right, and center. He's killing people left, right, and center.
Yeah. No remorse.
Yeah, it's hilarious.
Yeah. So. And considering how he's getting the boys together, so he does have to mediate here and there.
Right.
So that's really cool. And
talking about the boys, I had a really good time. I really liked Frenchie.
Yeah.
Who's this? He's shown as a French dude?
Yeah, Tinker.
Yeah, he knows a little about everything, is what he says.
Yeah, right at the start.
So, he's really fun. Frenchie's a lot of fun. Mother's Milk. His mother named him Mother's Milk for some reason.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's there in the series. Yeah. He's a lot of fun. I really enjoyed the boys as a whole, the dynamic, the way they bounce off each other.
Okay.
They're all different personalities. They don't seem like a one-note person, all of them.
Right.
It's good that you have multiple personalities that are very different from each other. And obviously, Huey, the main guy.
Yeah.
The most show is almost around, like centered towards him and him meeting Butcher. Huey, firstly, this guy is Dennis Quaid's son. And this guy looks like such an average guy. Like,
he looks like a Palika version of Dennis
such
Quaid's
an Aadmi. You're like, no, this is definitely not Dennis Quaid. That guy was a stud.
Yeah.
So, but yeah, and this guy, he brings that, you know, the common man charm to his character.
I guess like
him struggling in a world where everything's so being, you know, pulled, the strings are being pulled by corporates and, you know, he's powerless against these mighty gods.
Right.
So he joins the boys. So I really, really enjoyed that entire perspective.
Okay.
Another thing that I really liked was the gore, man. Like,
there's a little too much gore. Like, it catches you by surprise.
There's never too much gore. I'm a morbid guy, I know, but there's never too much gore.
The very first, I think it picks off where, you know, Huey is with his girlfriend.
Right? first episode.
Yeah, pretty much right on the starting, and that was like, I was like, what just happened? And they literally, yeah, and they slow it down.
Yeah, it's in slow motion.
Yeah,
right?
So you can see everything that's happening.
This guy who's on super speed, who's a ripoff of Flash, yeah, almost, he's called the A-Train. He runs through his girlfriend. And she dies because, yeah, it's just blood splattering everywhere. Yeah. And that becomes his motivation to, you know, go up against these superheroes. Yeah, so...
Soups, as they call it.
Soups, yeah. And I really enjoyed the gore. We call even when it's a Homelander doing his thing.
Oh, he just does his eye stuff like...
I mean, if I was Superman, I would be doing that laser beaming everybody. even if it's just for fun, I'd be doing that. So I get why they did that.
Yeah.
And I had a lot of fun.
Yeah.
And the abuses, man. Like,
oh my God. Butcher, just left, right and center.
I
just non-stop.
This is something, when it comes to superheroes, DC and Marvel are such huge properties.
Yeah.
But it's a shame that we won't see the kind of fun to be had here. We won't see it with those properties ever.
Yeah, because
they're so established and respected. And
yeah, and kids have to look up to these characters
exactly,
idols.
Exactly.
So this is very new territory.
Exactly. This is a satire, more or less.
Yeah,
it plays off of the superhero comedy genre on its own.
So yeah, so lots of new stuff, lots
absolutely.
Of fascinating stuff catches you by surprise.
Yeah.
Enough goods. Can we please do bads now?
He's got some shit to say. Let's get it.
I didn't like this series too much. I think, like I said, I survived because of Karl Urban's character Butcher.
I love the series. He's on his own right now.
Yeah, because the thing is, like, while I did like, I like Homelander, I like Butcher, I like Frenchie to a certain extent, but everyone else, I couldn't really latch on to them. You know, the other superheroes, the other guys in The Boys, just everything happening in and around. I mean, I was a little on the fence, so I didn't really sort of side with their motivations, I didn't get their character arcs. Another thing that we were talking about is that we didn't really understand why the suits are so bad, but I think that was actually purposely
done. I think that's intentional, right?
Right. So yeah, but besides that, just in terms of like the characters, the stories, the character arcs, the way it comes together.
I actually thought they did a decent job with all the character arcs per se. Maybe not very strong characters,
right?
But the arcs that they developed overall,
right.
I think I had a good time at least. I enjoyed it.
Yeah, I mean, probably if I was reading this and this is a comic,
right?
So I would probably, you know, give into it more. But yeah, minus, you know, Karl Urban's personality that totally shines.
He totally carries this movie, absolutely.
Right, like, and you're talking about Huey also and how we can't believe Dennis Quaid's son.
Yeah.
But he's, despite playing like the common man, the kind of fattu really well, again, like first he's a fattu, then the thing happens with his girlfriend, and then suddenly he's still a fattu, but then he's doing random weird ass things.
Yeah, I like the progression. Only thing that I didn't like about Huey's arc is his love life.
Yes.
Even the first love interest that he has with Robin. Which
first
is,
scene she's gone.
First scene she's dead. Like they should have let maybe build a little more.
Yeah, so we can feel for them.
Yeah, exactly. We latch onto them as a, you know, couple maybe, and then she dies, and you know, then you can probably get behind his motivation.
Yes.
But I think it's done too quick, too fast maybe. So yeah, that doesn't. And then the second love interest that he develops over the series, which is Starlight, who's actually a soup, and now these guys are, since they're going up against soups, he's kind of using her, but he's slowly
also
falling in love with her. Yeah, exactly. Is that typical Bollywood-y, you know, twist
slash dilemma.
So yeah, that's happening. And even the second, it's Starlight, I don't buy that too much either.
Right.
By the end of it, I was like, yeah, alright, you guys are maybe a little cute together, maybe.
Yeah,
but I don't believe the way that you guys fell in love together.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly, and I can get it from Starlight's perspective because because she's surrounded by bullshit.
She's
and she
surrounded
thought,
by assholes.
Yeah, and she thought, you know, she's made it, and then she realized the realities of it. Like the very first scene where like the Deep has his pants off and she's like, what is this? Where have I come? So yeah, so from her perspective I get it, but from his, I'm sorry, like I get how they were using this sort of plot to like you know, up his character and like sort of round it off well.
Right.
But yeah, this thing on the side just didn't make sense to me.
That's true. So even the love interest all in all didn't make sense to me, but overall Huey's arc where he's you know, a timid, shy guy who then stands up to superheroes, even though he's still fattu, he's still scared of them, but he's still standing up to them and he's slowly growing a pair of balls.
Yeah.
That entire arc I enjoyed, you know, towards the end where he's shooting people, and he's saying sorry and he's shooting people. I had fun with that. Let's get into Filmy.
Let's do this. Now that we've done good and bad, let's just get into why this is on the map, why it's got a 9+ rating on IMDb.
Yeah.
Is that, yeah, we mentioned it that, yeah, this is doing very different stuff and it sort of found a place to use something in the same world with superheroes yet. they've just gone bonkers.
They've turned everything upside down.
Right.
This is not your general superhero stuff.
Yes.
Because, the superhero fatigue is kind of real. It does kick in because you've got so many DC Marvel, movies coming in.
Yeah.
But this just completely takes everything and just switches it up.
Correct.
Which gives you a really nice perspective of where the boys are coming in from, how the superheroes are in a world where everything's being controlled by corporates.
Yes.
Which it is, even in our real lives, it is.
Yeah.
If there were superheroes that existed, they would be up there on television, there would be movies
social
on
media,
there, they would be on social media, there would be influencers.
Yes.
There would be corporates kind of using them for commercial purposes.
Yes.
Pulling strings. So I really, really enjoy that entire perspective, that entire world that they showed behind superheroes.
Yeah.
There's actually harassment going on at workplaces with superheroes. There's an HR who comes in, takes care of all such issues.
Yeah.
So it's very realistic. Even though satire, the way they've shuffled it up, the entire genre, I really had a good time with it.
Yeah, I mean, I guess I am on board with that in concept for sure. And they actually show that through Starlight's, sort of trajectory.
Absolutely.
Where, she's supposed to say certain things, and even though she's a superhero, she sort of goes out of her way and sort of defends like someone in need, and they're like, that was not cool, like you can't do that without telling us, like
exactly.
The cameras have to be ready and you're supposed to tell us that you're doing this, and we'll like analyze crime for you and we'll tell you when you can attack it and you can't. So it's just about how they're basically celebrities, they're these sort of personalities, and they're controlled by corporations, by money, they're doing brands, commercials, etc, etc. But at the end of the day, they still have human emotions.
Absolutely.
And while some are overtaken by greed, some are just tired and cut off. And Starlight, as her sort of character suggests, she is a, she has a light of a star.
Yeah,
she wants to do...
She's a goody two-shoes.
Yeah, she's Miss Goody Two-Shoes. And she's going through shit, like even her, she has issues with her mom, and she's the closest person to her. Which is why, she falls for Huey and stuff. So I think the way they sort of, picked up this world and put these superheroes in them, that's, I think, fleshed out really, really well. So, lots of cool stuff.
Absolutely. And I really enjoy how different this is. Again, I can't emphasize on this too much. DC and Marvel, I love both the brands.
Right.
But this is such a nice, different, fresh take.
Yeah.
And I'm always up for something new that's happening. This for me is very new as a concept.
Yeah.
And I really like this. I can't wait to see where season 2 takes us, because there's a lot happening towards the end of the season.
Yes, there is.
I'm really expecting some nice, big, major set pieces now that maybe superheroes might be coming into the play.
Right.
So it's the asshole supervillains versus the even worse
superheroes.
So I don't know how that's going to be, but I think it's going to be a lot of fun.
Yes.
I enjoyed the series overall. I know you did not too much. Let's just wrap this up.
Ratings, please.
Let's get into the ratings.
Okay.
So I really enjoyed the series. I really like the boys. I like the supporting cast. Carl Urban, I can't emphasize on enough. He's an amazing actor.
Right.
He carries the series single-handedly.
Yeah.
Homelander was kick-ass as a villain. I can't wait to see more of this guy. This guy is a surprise. Like you can't pin him down.
Yeah.
Every time he's on screen, you're like, what's gonna happen next? So all in all, I had a really good time with the series. I'm definitely looking forward to season 2. I think it's gonna be bigger and better.
Yeah.
So I would definitely give this 2 thumbs up.
Nice. Don't hate me. Like, yes, I watched it and I watched it once. But no, for me, it's I'm sorry, this is a one-time watch. I don't think so. I'm gonna come back to this. I'll watch season 2 because I'm curious to see where they go from here. But it's not something that I'm gonna like rave about and tell my friends that, you guys have to watch this and stuff. Because, I'm biased towards, what I like on screen, and I appreciate the new take. But like I said, I just couldn't latch on to certain things going on.
Right.
Been there, done that. But let's see. I hope season 2 will change my opinion.
Changes your opinion for sure.
Yeah.
So that wraps up our review part.
Yep.
And there's a lot more content coming your way really soon. We're working on a lot of new different things.
Yeah.
A lot of different things for us as well.
Yes.
So I'm really excited for that. Please guys, be back for that. Like, share, subscribe as usual. We love you guys.
Cool. See you guys. Cheers.
Cheers.
Thank you so much for watching, man. We're good.
Bad.
And Filmy. And we're going to be doing a lot of stuff like this, be it Netflix, be it big screen, Hollywood, Bollywood, you name it.
Yeah, MCU, DCU, all of it.
All of it, yeah. So stay tuned, man. Please like, share, subscribe.
Yeah.
We're going to be doing fun stuff pretty much every week.
We love you guys. Thank you so much for all your love and support. Be back for more.
Yo.